With Nick Gordon's arrest for Stig violence and investigators building the case for Bobby Christina Brown's death, considering that arrest to be evidence, it looks like he's going to have some prison time in his future. But the question of how much will depend on prosecution and on evidence, and a new report suggests that Bobby Christina's family is willing to pull out all of the stops to make sure that he goes away. Even if that means exhuming Bobby Christina's body for a new autopsy. According to Radar Online, Bobby Christina's family wants an exhumation and a second autopsy to make sure that any and all evidence needed for Nick Gordon's arrest and conviction is found. I think they should exhume Bobby Christina's body, and make a determination as to the fact that Nick Gordon murdered her. He was responsible for her death. That comes from a family source, Radar Online reports. Unfortunately, even though Bobby Christina's still grieving family may not want to accept it, autopsies don't always yield conclusive answers. Even when autopsies definitely show that someone was murdered, that doesn't mean that they contain evidence that points to the killer. This isn't some decades-old cold case dating back to before DNA could be sampled from a few epithelial cells. Bobby Christina died on July 26, 2015, after spending 6 months in a coma. And that was after being found unresponsive in her bathtub, which was massively suspicious. An extended hospital stay and the bathwater itself would have made an autopsy much less helpful. We have to remember that, at the time, the priority was the attempt to save her life. If someone were buried immediately after death, there's sometimes some bruising that wouldn't show up right away that might be found with an exhumation and autopsy. 6 months after the events that caused someone's death, though, if that's your best autopsy, then no later autopsies are going to yield much. Unless we wait a few decades for forensic tech that's currently science fiction. We know that they're hurting over this, but this would put them through more suffering and wouldn't bring them any of the closure that they seek. And we can't see it helping the case against Nick Gordon. The claims from this family source get a little more intense from there. The new case demonstrates Nick's pattern of abuse against women. His father was abusive. His grandfather was abusive. It's in his DNA. That's why he can't stop. Okay, to be clear, there's no evidence that genetics work that way. Addiction struggles or anger issues could certainly have powerful genetic factors. But if there's a domestic violence gene, science has yet to prove it. We're oversimplifying genetics, we know. Since genes themselves can simply be active or inactive at different times to different effects, but still. We're not arguing that Nick Gordon doesn't have a horrifying pattern of behavior. We're just suggesting that genes probably aren't the primary factor here. If somebody comes from a line of abusers and is abusive himself, it's probably a learned behavior. A lot of abusive parents are that way because they were raised in abusive households. Though they wouldn't use that label for their parents any more than for themselves. Similarly, a lot of partner abusers learned that behavior from a parent. There are things that can help put Nick Gordon behind bars. Obviously, his current arrest is a major part of that. Nick Gordon's latest alleged victim sees clear parallels to Bobby Christina and says that she could have died the same way. It's worth noting that her case, she talks about being held down and beaten until she thought she might die, only escaping because she managed to hit him with a candlestick and run, bleeding, to his mother for sanctuary, is its own thing. Like, that kind of monstrous assault that she describes deserves the most severe penalties that the justice system can offer, and then some. We shouldn't look at her case exclusively as evidence for Nick Gordon's eventual murder trial, which we don't know will even happen. That said, authorities are building their case and carefully reviewing evidence related to Bobby Christina's death. Nobody wants a repeat of O.J. Simpson or Casey Anthony or George Zimmerman or, well, the list goes on. Nobody wants a deadlocked jury like with Bill Cosby, either. That means building a solid case with great care. It also means not rushing things. It's not unusual for a case to take years to build. We totally understand that Bobby Christina's family is eager for justice. Just as millions of fans and admirers are, but infinitely more personally. But we all need to keep in mind that rushing through things won't bring her justice. Patience, folks.